Hey buddy, everyone knows that Linux is far more better compared to Windows. You can basically forget about any viruses, malware, or any other harmful software that exists on Windows. Linux gives you more control over when to update and what software is installed on your computer. Linux has less overhead than Windows, resulting in a smoother experience. Linux user privilege management is far more superior than Windows. If I continue, it would take a few hours to talk about Windows versus Linux. But here are top 3 desktop Linux distros for users that are thinking to try out Linux for the first time. Zorin OS is the most Windows 10-like operating system in my opinion. It also certainly has better user interface consistency than Windows 10. By the way, we now have a Patreon page. If you like my content and want to encourage me to learn more and make better videos, please consider supporting me on Patreon. By supporting me, you get to watch all my videos 2 days before I publish on YouTube. Check the description for the link. Where were we before? Oh yeah, Zorin OS. If you have been a Windows Vista or Windows 7 user, clicking on the menu will feel right at home as the apps are categorized into lists along with the sidebar where you will find your user account, quick access to different folders in your home directory, and shortcuts to store, settings, and activities overview along with the logout, lock, and shutdown buttons all neatly laid out. The search on the menu feels more quick and snappy than Windows 10's search interface. Zorin OS comes with Firefox pre-installed, but installing any other popular internet browser is as simple as opening the store, searching for the browser that you would like to install, and clicking on the install button, and finally entering your password. Once the installation is done, you can launch the app by just clicking on the launch button. Next to the Firefox icon in the taskbar, you will find the file manager, which has just enough features for a new user with support for opening multiple tabs, which even Windows Explorer doesn't have. Moving forward, we have the store, which we just opened to install an alternative internet browser. On the right side of the taskbar, we have the system tray with sound, network, user options, along with a shortcut that directly takes you to the settings app, which looks very organized and easy to navigate. Lastly, on the taskbar is the clock, which when clicked shows your calendar, notifications, and weather all in one single menu. Zorin OS taskbar feels more minimalist and clear than the cluttered Windows 10 taskbar layout. The second operating system is Solus. Unlike Zorin OS, which is based on Ubuntu, Solus is an independent operating system, meaning any tutorials and articles written for Ubuntu won't work in Solus. Also, Solus has less number of software packages than Ubuntu. While commonly used Linux software is available on Solus, applications that do specific things aren't. If Solus had more number of software in its repositories, it would be the perfect OS for new Linux users coming from Windows. Talking about the desktop, the layout is pretty similar to Windows and comes along with a sidebar called the Raven menu, which has tabs. The Applets tab is where you have the calendar and the controls for your audio devices, and Notifications tab is where you will see the received notifications. Solus comes with Firefox pre-installed, but installing Google Chrome is very simple thanks to the custom-made Software Center, where you head over to the third-party tab and click on the blue install button next to Google Chrome and enter your password. I would say, try Solus for a week and see if that works out. If you find all the software that you need, then Solus works great. A lot of long-term Linux users recommend Linux Mint for new users, though I feel like Linux Mint lacks the elegant look and feel that Windows 10 or Zorin OS have. Still, Linux Mint is based on Ubuntu, so you won't have the problem of not finding the software that you need. Clicking on the menu, you will find that the layout follows the same categories on the left and applications on the right style. But now we have the search bar on the top with an additional area where you can pin your favorite apps for quick access. Next to the menu, you will find the Show Desktop button, which is on the right corner of the taskbar in Windows 10. Linux Mint also comes with Firefox as the default browser, but installing Chromium or any other internet browser is just as simple as searching for Software Manager in the menu, opening it, and then searching for your preferred internet browser, once found, clicking on it, and then clicking on the install button and putting your password. The file manager that comes with Linux Mint has certainly more features than the file manager in Solus or Zorin OS. Also, you can customize Linux Mint more extensively than you can do with Zorin OS or Solus. Well, if you're watching this video till now, here is a bonus distribution you might like. Kubuntu is one of the official flavors of Ubuntu, featuring the K desktop environment, or more popularly known as KDE. Kubuntu provides you with a highly customizable desktop, where the limit is your imagination. Also, the default desktop layout is pretty similar to Windows 10's desktop. If you are still unable to decide which Linux distro to pick up, even after watching this video, I would say Zorin OS will be a good choice. If you are okay with getting used to a different desktop layout, then why not try macOS or Manjaro Linux? Linux is not as hard as it was a few years ago. A lot of things are constantly being improved in Linux. If you are thinking to game on Linux, this is the best time, as now we have built-in support for AMD graphics cards as well as Steam, Wine, Play on Linux, and Lutris to help you play your Windows games on Linux. So, that was it for this video. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos like this. This is Vasan Developer, signing off.